Hello everybody, today we're gonna continue this game. We last left off where we talked to everybody and we're still missing one person, I assume. So we're just gonna search this room and wait the other person to come. Okay. Okay, let's start with this. This porthole tightly sealed to from the inside and the outside. It seems as well as the padlock seem very heavy and large, it will require some professional equipment to get rid of it. Too bad I don't have my tools with me. Okay, I think I saw something here. Yes, the writing. What are these writings? Thrills are inside. Come in. That's very odd. My heart started pounding just by reading it. The man who wrote this must have a pokey humor. What do you think it could mean? It means that my assumptions are confirmed. The real business is waiting for us behind this door. Well, it's not very encouraging, but it really feels like a mockery. It's upsetting. Obviously, it was the point of it. Retorting us with his pseudo-humoristic writings. I can't really tell whether she's trying to express her fear or trying to scare me. And this little face next to it, I've already seen it somewhere, but I can't put my finger in it. That's in the invitation letter you got. When I told you to come here. Don't you remember it? It's a recurring visual around here though. A recurring visual around here? And what is it? Invitation letter? Exactly. It resembles the little face that was on the invitation envelope. How do you know I received one? I doubt that you and your two little friends chose to come to this room haphazardly. But what sort of incriminating question was that? Ha, that Claire, she's not very happy. Excuse me, I have been acting paranoid since I found myself stuck in this place. But anyway, what is this little face supposed to be? Why are they drawing this everywhere? This might be our horse trademark. A lot of felons like to have their own trademark. Creeping out on me again, too bad, I saw it coming. What makes you think so, dear Humby? Well, that sounds very sarcastic, but I guess you could say that's my sixth sense. Or the fact that I'm a lifeless man in his late 20s who spent his Sundays watching crime TV shows. Ha! I knew he was older than a high school student. He doesn't look that age. I mean, he looks young, but not that young. Well, that was too many informations. He must be messing with me again. And it really doesn't help figuring out what it could mean. There's really one in every room. I still don't understand their purpose though. I wonder if it could be a thermal camera, like the other woman hypothesized. On the other hand, I somewhat doubt it. Somehow I get the feeling that someone's currently monitoring us with it. I literally have goosebumps just thinking about it. Ha! That's all messing my brain! What's wrong? Well, I woke up in this weird room I've never been to, and yet I noticed that some of my belongings were there. It's like if I had brought my stuff with me, then I lost my mind shortly afterward. What if I was that weirdo who trapped us here and brought them up? That's making a disturbing man. It is true, the same thing happened to me. I even found my undergarments in one of the drawers. How humiliating. Well, that's interesting. The only thing that could be interesting would be to know if anyone has an account that differs from the usual events. Well, for me, I did not wake up in one of those bedrooms. Oh? Pardon me for being so late. I'm coming straight from a weird room in which I found an invitation letter, so... Eh? The door! It is opened! The moment he's come, now it's time to see the face of the individual behind this preposterous performance. Before that, is anyone able to tell what's going on? Well, I wouldn't really have the time to talk it all over again, just tag along. Yep, should have been an early bird. Well, if that's so... Ooh, let's see the surprise. But the one with the mask said he didn't wake up in the bedroom? Okay, that's weird. We should talk about it more. It was finally time for explanations. Nothing was guaranteed for us as we were slowly starting to understand how surreal the situation was. It felt like trying to cross a road blindfolded, unable to predict if a car is going to hit you or not. However, beneath this monstrous amount of tenseful dread, I felt a bit relieved to know that I was not alone, that I was not the only one to endure this. We were finally ready to confront it and see the face of a disturbed mind. We were all bitterly eager to hear out the motives for all of this staging. We were, well, it's not like it was easy to explain such an abstruse story with such mundane words. Our vocabulary hardly has ever needed the right terms to describe such circumstances. It probably doesn't even have enough practical knowledge for it. But either way, my brain was so distraught that the world simply became a confusing notion. The only one that I could picture in my mind was survival. Here, let's see. It was so distressing, a crashing rush of adrenaline suddenly started to hurtle through my bloodstream. It caused my heart to pump so frantically that I was able to hear my own heartbeat vibrate all the way up to my ears. The room we were in was dyed into a grey hue that was emphasizing its otherworldly aspect. Faint, echoing electronic sounds were harmonized with a mechanical melody that felt as if we had been swallowed by a robot and we were slowly traveling through its digestive system. But strangely, in a contradiction with the crippling feeling of fear, the room casted a curious tranquility. Oh my, what a cutting edge architecture, very futuristic. So neo-futuristic. Look like one of those laboratories in which they conduct experiments. Plot twist is, we are an experiment subject. Don't be saying gnosis, Yonano, there isn't any twisted experiment going on. I have said that a little too firmly because in the end I feel that it could be a possibility. But everything has been bullcrap so far. I'm tired of waiting, that's crushing my nerves now. Please, be me to imagine what you... The screen, it fits done. It was in the far back of the room. It was hard to define what sort of technology it was. Two kind of towering technological cones were transmitting a black hologram-like screen that was steadily hovering in midair. It seemed indefinable due to its advanced looking technology. And it wasn't just a module, it was real. And it had switched itself on.
Chotto.
Is that a joke? Waiting so long just for this? What a grotesque turn of events. That's a puppet! Hey, puke face! You may call me grotesque, but how dare you referring to me as a mere puppet? It has exploded back! Is it a robot? Ah, whether it is a robot or a puppet, it looks so adorable! Is it? Of course I'm cute! Desirable is my second name, baby! But now, enough with the jokes, because it's time for my introduction. Welcome, my dear blockheads! Here you are in the octagon room! My name is Dokuroku, and it is with a tremendous delight that I can finally see your dead mouth. What's that damn mouth of yours? I saw yourself already, because I'm getting pissed. Totally gonna damn brain gum gum. What? Okay. It's my face, what are you assuming? What I'm assuming is that the damn puppeteer who's playing with his ugly ass toy is taking us for a bunch of circuses. Puppeteer? I don't want such to fulfill this role. Ooh, that was a bit scary. But since your level of ineptitude is going off the charts, I suppose proof of my realness won't be too luxurious. What is that? Did it just jump out of the screen? It's not physically possible. is defying the laws. This used to be a nightmare. Nightmare, I tell you. A nightmare? Yeah, you see those heavenly cubic bands of mine? It can't be anything but a robot, right?
I know.
Even if it's a robot, I never heard about technology that allows some sort of quantum teleportation. Ugh. Yeah, simpleton number one, listen to what simpleton number two said with your gibberish slang. Now stop with the puppet and robot crap. There is no puppeteer. No programmer, no take your mind out of the frame, you madness.
Hi, hi.
You entranced a little baffle my expectation, Dokuroku. Oh. But it's not time and place to be mesmerized, so get on with your explanation. Clarify the reason why you summoned us here. There's a question we've been awaiting for so long. While standing like a haughty blockhead that you are, how imprudent. But okay, I'm going to explain why you're here. Time is now to a selling business. You see, each of you blockheads can be invited for a specific reason. An obnoxious, albeit thrilling reason. Each one of you, raw brains, are the betrayers who thwarted the commencement of the world's final order. What's that again? That's crazy talk.
Tadashi.
Don't like the way the word final sounds like. What's that crap again? Well, in the past, it was a cliché to imagine that the world would turn into a dystopia. But he's been slowly and secretly drifting to the scent, unbeknownst to the great public. But it's okay. It is soon time to reset the world and conceive with an utopic picture in mind. However, you both had my plans. It went over it. I didn't do anything. But, well, I do not remember anything as such.
Demo ne.
This will not be very courteous of me to partake in such havocking activities. Don't trust it. This toy is spitting out lies.
だけど.
Weird puppet, two questions on my account. Who is our in our plans, and how is it because of us? It feels like you insinuating that we were all together on this. In fact, the story goes a little further than that. So shut up and listen. I had my plan to make the world a better place, but you meddled up in my affairs and slowed down its process. But literally, you put a code on it, a code that prevented the project from expanding.
Huh?
A code? Yes, a code. When you heard about my plan to bring humankind to the next step, you wanted to interfere with it. So you went to your keyboards, screens, then hacked my systems to set a code in order to stop everything from working. Seemingly, this seemed like a good idea in your mind, but not anymore. Because now, in order to proceed with the world's final order project, I need to extract the code out of your memory. If what you said, then of course it's not. What the girl is saying are pure fibs. We have memory defects, Fujita. It's not time to get a grip on what's happening. As long as you don't remember anything, we won't be able to affirm what has been done or not, even for us. So we're just going to nod and accept what this thing is saying.
Hi.
Exactly. And from here, we'll make up our own mind from the gathered information. But now my question is,
それで...
if what Dokuroku says is true, that we have for some reasons interfered with the project and put a locking code to block the system, how is it planned to retrieve this locking code from our memory if the last pages of our existence are blank and empty? Because truthfully, I do remember my family, my name, my college years, but the last few years of my life seems to have vanished. Oh my, it's a question, translate her guy. I will retrieve this locking code from your memory with the use of your personal key. You cannot. Bring out devices with a very sophisticated safety system. If you intend to access our prism by hacking them, let me tell you that this won't be doable.
だけど...
It's true though. The hack grinding antennas from their names literally grind in the prism net hacking procedure. So it's not really possible to hack one's prism. Oh, nincompoops that you are. Heki! Bad news though. Because here you are in the Tetra facility, one of the most inaccessible places in which the hiking grinding antennas reduce kennel trees. There's no such place! Hell, shut the hell up! So trying to be the loudmouth! And if I'm not mistaken here, your prints have been acting rather queer, haven't they? true, but my prism behavior has been strangely lately. Well, that's bad for me then, because I still have lots of memories that I wouldn't want anyone to hear about. However, if you want to retrieve something from my memories, why have you caused our memory loss in the first place? Which person? Not the cause of your amnesia, it's a third person twink, and you might soon discover who it was if you retrieve your memories. But in the meantime, even if you cannot remember them, your memories are still there, somewhere. And if we want to retrieve the unlocking memory that contains the locking code, we'll have to probe your prims until we find out who has it.
Ano.
Only one has a memory code then? Yeah! Although you worked all together on your missives, only one of you has created the code. But how are you going to guess who it was? Oh, but we won't bother, Kiki, yeah? Every 3 days, one of you will be mind-hacked and so on until that we finally find the one with the unlocking memory. Mind-hack? What does that term mean? It's a term that is specific to a certain type of hacking. Mind-hack doesn't only hack the brain, it also connects with the host brain in a way. The downside is that mind-hacking someone can cause them to fall into comatose. Or worse, roughly speaking, it can disconnect the brain. Wait, what's that? Are you kidding me?
Who are you?
I wanna die! What the fidgety is that bullshit? Are you trying to mean that we're gonna lucky kill us for a freaking code? Kinda. But can't we find the consensus and alternative solution? No, and sacrifice is sometimes necessary for redemption, baby. But as for now, before the first mindhack takes place, which will be after tomorrow, be patient and enjoy the thrills. After all, maybe the first one to get mindhacked will have their lucky memory and everyone else will get to leave. Or maybe not. Stop wonkling our balls, it's not funny. Kiana looks pretty mad. I haven't known her for too long, but it feels a little strange seeing her like that. We need to establish who's got the unlocking memory. Show yourself, betrayer. You are as much of a betrayer as we all are. For all we know, it could be you. I know, I was sure my look was too rad for me to look innocent.
Demo.
Besides, it's unnecessary to ask who it is. The bearer of this memory people cannot even remember themselves. It's not useless to remind you that we all have this nonsensical memory loss caused by a demented third person with obscure motives. But what if a bearer of this memory is actually the culprit behind our amnesia, and so they're all now faking their own memory loss? Huh, interesting. Well, that's a thorn in the food right there. But that would be the best scenario indeed. It'd be easier for us to make someone spit out the secret than attempt at getting information from an amnesic person. You know, I believe I told you enough for you to discover the rest of it. And anyways, you might discover it soon enough because after all, it will be necessary if you survive. And last question? If you suggest, I have one, so pardon me for reiterating my question, but I'm having a hard time coping with it. All of these people in this room, myself included, truly the doers of such an fiery deed. Oh yeah, you're naughty bad. Kinda cool though. Whatever, Blobblane. Now I shall retire to my quarters. I really want you to have a peaceful reason and to visit the rest of the building. You have an excursion! So once again, are we going to be okay with that enabling wonk around? We need to be attentive, there might be something after all. Any further clues will reveal whether it's a joke or not. I suppose it would be fair to give it a try. Clues, we need to search out for clues. Everyone left the room with eyes either filled with anger or confusion, or maybe even both. The situation had been so mind-boggling that it became hard to cope with only one feeling or one emotion at a time. Our minds, which were already faulty, were utterly distraught at this point. I was really unable to keep my mind clear. It was also hard to put it in place, like attempting to solve a jigsaw with unfitting pieces. We were explaining that in our past, we had been once part of a group whose goal was to stop a certain project from improving the world's condition. But for some reason, none of us could remember it. I was really unable to accept that. Why would I have done such apparent doings? I was not against improving our parliament. I really wasn't. But Secret Tarsin made it that I really couldn't deny what Humpy had said. Since we were incapable of recollecting any memory about any specific period of our past, anything could have happened during this blackout. But then... did I really do it, or was there an underlying double meaning to this discombobulating story? Okay, I'll leave it at that. So we found out, not the actually the mastermind of who brought us here and kidnapped us, and that, and now we have to suspect that maybe someone here is the one that gave us the amnesia, and they think about the mind hack. Every 3 days someone will die. That sounds awful. I really like some of the characters already, so I don't want anyone to die. But we'll go and search for clues at the next video. Thank you very much for watching, and if you like it, please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you at the next video.